Jaya Jagannatha, Jaya Jagannatha, Jaya Baladeva, Jaya Subhadra, Jaya Krishna Balaram.
Jaksurmiritam jena tasmai Sri Gurave namaha Sri Chaitanya mano vistam stapitam jena bhuttare Svayam rupa kadamahyam vidatti svapadantikam Vandeham Sri Gurau Sri Gita padakamalam Sri Gurum Vaishnavam Shyam Rupam Saprajatam Sahagana Raghunatam Ditantam Sajivam
Sadvaitam Sadvaitam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padam Sahajana Lalita Sri Vishakanditam Cha. He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostate Tata Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vishapanu Sukhe Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpa Trivyascha Kripa Sindhu Jarevacha Patitanam Pavanejo
Vaishnavevyo Namo Namaha
Narayanam Namaskritya
Narayanam Namaskritya Naram Jaiva Narottamam
Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam
Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam Tato Jaya Mudirayet Nashta Praya Svavadresu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavate Uttama Sloke Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtaki Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare
Rama Hare Rama
Hare Rama Hare Rama
Rama Rama Hare Hare
Rama Rama Hare Hare
Om Namo Bhagavate
Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Shri Surabhyay Namaha
Om Shri Surabhyay Namaha
Om Shri Surabhyay Namaha
Om Shri Surabhyay Namaha Om Shri Surabhyaya Namaha
Mukham Karoti Vasanam Pangum Langayate Girim Yat Kripa Uttamaham Bande Sri Guram Vinataram Yat Kripa Uttamaham Bande Sri Guram Vinataram Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Last few days we have been reading from the first canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam. In the context of Bhishma Dev, and Yudhisthira Maharaj. Was the verse? passing away of Bhishma Dev in the presence of Lord Krishna and in the context of the Bhishma Panchaka, last days of Kartik, to try and appreciate and remember the austerities performed by Bhishma Dev, to try and remember actually so many things in connection with Bhishma Dev, who is one of the 12 Mahajans, and who was chosen. It was Krishna's arrangement, as we know, that amongst so many exalted personalities who were there, that Krishna, including Srila Vyasadeva, including Narada Muni and others, the Lord Krishna chose that Bhishma Dev should be the person consoling Yudhishthira Maharaj. So we've been listening to various instructions given by Bhishma Dev that touches on different aspects. And today we will just read from text number 21. Sarvat Manaha.
20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20.
Yam manyase matuleyam
priyam mitram suhrutam
akaro sachivam dutam
sahrudam atasaradim
Yam manyase matuleyam
priyam mitram suhrutam
Yam manyase matuleyam priyam mitram suhrutam akaro sachivam dutam
Manyase,
you think. Matuleyam,
maternal cousin.
Priyam,
very dear.
Mitram, friend.
Surittamam,
ardent well wisher.
Akaroho,
executed.
Sachivam.
Council.
Dutam.
Messenger.
Sauridat.
By goodwill.
Atha.
Thereupon.
Sarathim.
Charioteer.
Translation and purport
by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki. O King, so this is Bhishma Dev speaking to Yudhishthira Maharaj. O King, that personality whom out of ignorance only you thought to be your maternal cousin, your very dear friend, well-wisher, counselor, messenger, benefactor, etc., is that very personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna. Kindly repeat after me. O King. That personality whom? Out of ignorance only. You thought to be. Your maternal cousin.
Your very dear friend.
Well-wisher.
Counselor.
Messenger.
Benefactor, etc.
Is that personality of God?
Sri Krishna.
Lord Sri Krishna, although acting as the cousin, brother, a friend, a well-wisher, counselor, messenger, benefactor, etc., of the Pandavas, was still the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Out of His causeless mercy and favor upon His unalloyed devotees, He performs all kinds of service, but that does not mean that He has changed His position as the Absolute Person. To think of Him as an ordinary man is the grossest type of ignorance. Here, Bhishma Dev is glorifying the Supreme Personality of Krishna. reminding Yudhishthira Maharaj that although the Lord performs seemingly many ordinary activities, seemingly many menial activities such as being messenger, such as being a chariot driver for Arjuna, because he is the Suridam Sarva Bhutanam, always the well-wisher of all living entities. Although he performs these seemingly ordinary activities, he always remains in his transcendental position. That's explained, of course, by Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita. We were quoting, I think, the other day, Avajananti mam bhuta manushim matanum asritam param bhavam ajananto mama bhuta maheshwaram. So fools deride me, explaining, when I descend in this material world, thinking that I have assumed an ordinary human form. The Lord appears in this material world to perform wonderful activities, and as Prabhupada would often explain, and our acharyas also, although he appears for different purposes, again as explained in the Bhagavad Gita, to annihilate the demons, to give association or pleasure to his devotees, and dharma samsthapanarthaya, to re-establish the principles of religion. His main purpose for appearing, actually, you can just understand the very unique and exalted position of the Lord. He has unlimited liberated souls with whom he associates in the spiritual world, but he likes to come down in the material world to associate with other living entities. It's like someone going in a prison house. There are so many people, most people are not in the prison, but to show special favor, and also because the Lord is very, he's very attached, he's very close, he's very he's very intimate with all living entities, and we see by his descending and coming in the material world, not only occasionally, but again and again through so many different incarnations. his main purpose is to help the living entities reestablish their lost relationship with him. Just like a caring father, even though one of his sons may leave the home, he's always meditating and thinking about that son, even though the son may have forgotten him. So that's our position in the material world. forgotten. Actually, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, one of our foremost acharyas, he explains how the greatest sinful activity that we have committed, and it takes us a long time to even begin understanding that the greatest sinful activity of the living entity is having rejected Krishna, isn't it? It's like you have a very, very close friend in this world who's always looking after you, caring for you, doing so many things, like Krishna performs so many activities for his devotees, and then you you reject or forsake that relationship. So of course Bhishma Dev in his discourse, in his conversation with Yudhisthira Maharaj, we'll be speaking especially about the duties of a king. He will be speaking about how a king actually should be playing the role of a caring father as well. The first and foremost activity of kings, or anyone who is in a leadership position, anyone who has dependence, is to give protection, isn't it? To give protection to those dependents. That protection sometimes may be physical protection. The most important protection, of course, to give to one's dependents, the most important service is to give them an opportunity to become self-realized, to give them an opportunity to fully, completely engage in devotional service Krishna, so that those living entities can qualify to go back home, back to Godhead. So the major instructions given by Bhishma Dev, of course, are in connection with the duties and responsibilities of a king, of a kshatriya. And in our present context today of modern society, there's actually a very great need for people to know that actually in the Vedic culture, in our Shastra, and there are so many guidelines given, and also this is important for our own devotees within ISKCON society, to learn what we could call the science of kshatriyahood. Has anyone ever attended a seminar on the science of kshatriyahood? I also have not. because it's not something very popular. Has anyone attended a science on, or a seminar rather, on the science of economics? Within ISKCON? In the outside world, there are all kinds of seminars on economics, because that's like in the main preoccupation for everyone. their understanding of economics is how to make money, how to make money. But that is not at all the meaning or the understanding, and that's why this particular section and the Mahabharata, here the Bhagavatam, we're just getting a very very brief, you could say, presentation of what Bhishmadev goes on and on and on in detail to describe the whole system of, ultimately the system of Varna and Asrama. Because when we begin to know the various the various levels of how society is meant to be arranged, first and foremost to facilitate that people practice Krishna consciousness. Prabhupada sometimes would explain, if people are in such a, let's say, poverty-stricken condition, or they are assailed by so many problems and anxieties, they're forced to be on the body platform and cannot even begin thinking about God. So Vedic culture actually gives importance to meeting our material needs, that is the meaning of kama and artha, dharma,
artha,
kama,
moksha,
artha and moksha. Yeah. But that needs to be understood in its proper context, and we can only do that when we hear from authorized authorities like Bhishmadev, who's one of the 12 Mahajans. So therefore, it's important for devotees to know what is the actual standard in society, what is meant to be the standard. Just like we know that in human form of life, the actual standard is to practice Krishna consciousness, is to understand that we're not this body and that primary activity should be in connection with the spirit soul. At the same time, because we have this body, because we are in the material world, Krishna has also given very, very clear, very scientific systems on how we should live. I was just reading this morning, one devotee sent a text in one of our forums that generally is not very active, but on cow. There's a forum on the cow protection in Tamil, but nowadays somehow, for some reason, is not very active. But this devotee was pointing out how most of us who have some little understanding about the importance of cow, we tend to forget, and this was something that our former minister for cow protection and agriculture, Balabhadra Prabhu, he would very often point this out because he was quite expert and knowledgeable about cow protection, being the minister and for so many years looking himself personally after cows. The point in that text and the point that Balabhadra Prabhu would be making also is that the cow, of course, is important, but also most important are how to utilize bulls, which is primarily in terms of producing our own food. Of course, bulls have many services that they perform, but that's the foremost service. So that's a whole culture, which unfortunately, as we know, is forgotten, has practically been lost for so many different reasons. So part of what Bhishma Dev here is explaining to Yudhishthira Maharaj are these different, we could say, principles which are both spiritual principles in terms of here in this verse especially he's referring to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, and how even though he descends in this material world to seemingly perform ordinary activities, we should never forget that he is always in his original transcendental position, that all of his activities are dibhyam, and that those who understand this, as Krishna explains in that same verse, jama karma samidhivyam evam jovetti tatvataha tyaktva deham punar jatma naiti mam naiti sorjuna. One will, again, not have to take birth in this material world and qualify to back home, to go back home, back to Godhead. So therefore, very, very important to understand such instructions that are given by such a personality as Bhishma Dev. Same thing actually later on in the Bhagavatam. Here, Yudhishthira Maharaj is receiving instructions from Bhishma Dev. Later on, after being enthroned, he will, even though he's heard, I mean, so many instructions from this great personality, Bhishma Dev, later on he will want to hear again on the same subject matter instructions from Narada Muni, isn't it? In the seventh canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, when Narada Muni visits. And just to remind ourselves, actually the whole mentality and the whole purpose in the Vedic culture is to remind us of our duties to Dharma, isn't it? And actually, Narada Muni begins his instructions to Yudhishthira Maharaj by giving this very nice quote where he explains about Dharma. Dharma mulam hi bhagavan sarva vidam ayo harihi smritam chat vidam rajan yena chatma prasidati. Which means that dharma is actually is meant to be where we find the essence of things. What is the essence of Dharma? Dharma is Krishna. And Sarva Veda Mayo Hari, all the Vedic literatures, all the Shastras, they point to that same, they are written for that same purpose. All the different sections of the Vedic literatures, whether it is Smriti Shastra or Sru Shruti Shastra, they are there to help us link and connect with Krishna. And our business and our purpose, that's also explained in the verse, Smritam Cha Tadidam Rajan, O my dear King, those who are devotees, those who are sadhus, they will be smriti, they will be endeavoring constantly to remember the Lord, to remember their duties,